This technicality episode is brought to you by Audible. You have an incredible superpower you don't even know you have. Check this out. I'm gonna play two different videos of me saying two different things at the same time. The first time you watch them, focus on this video right here and try to understand as much as possible. Once you're done with that, rewatch the clips again and try to focus on the other video. Even though they're played at the same exact time, if you focus on one, I bet you'll be able to hear it clearly. If you have headphones, put them on now because it'll make things a bit easier, but you can also do this without headphones. Here we go.
Hello, I think the last name is kind of overrated at this point, but I like it nonetheless. My favorite meme these days has got to be the EU banning memes meme, because, I mean, Article 13 is ridiculous. Don't Dark has a video on us.
Whoa. I really hope that worked for you, because it did for me, and that was amazing. Even though I was watching two different videos that together sounded like jumbled nonsense, if I focused on one, I was actually able to understand that video. This is the superpower you didn't know you had, the cocktail party effect. Hey guys, I'm here, let's get technical. I went to VidCon last week, and I had an amazing time. I met and talked with tons of fascinating people. But in the middle of one conversation I had with some people amidst a large and noisy conference room, I kinda lost focus and started looking around.
I know, right? I'm great at this.
And in that moment, when I let my attention wander, I realized how insanely loud the room was. Nothing against the organizers of that particular event, of course, there were just a lot of people in the room. And when I took in all the sounds, the voices of the people I was talking to could barely be heard. But when I snapped out of it and focused back in on the conversation I was having, I could hear them just fine. The cocktail party effect is your mind's ability to do just that, to filter out all of the other sounds in a noisy environment and focus in on the discussion you're having. If you're an absolute mad lad, you might even be able to use the cocktail party effect to distinguish between three voices at the same time.
So I was watching the B-movie the other day,
and this one comes by Hunnic.
The echo is incredibly hard, and the downhill is incredibly scary, but you know,
like 2,000 feet up, and they can overpower the viewer. It's beautiful. If you want to know for sure what I was saying in each of those clips, I'll reveal it at the end of the video. The effect was first discovered in 1953 by Colin Cherry, when he was in a bit of a predicament, and not just any old predicament. As far as predicaments go, this predicament was a big predicament. Predicament no longer sounds like a word. See, Cherry was an air traffic controller, but he wasn't late for work, allowing him to cut a line at a hot dog stand. I really hope you get that reference. But when he was controlling air traffic, all of the voices from all of the different pilots coming out of the loudspeaker made each of them inaudible. Thus, he decided to study human attention and the cocktail party effects, and published his findings in this paper. You may have noticed that during the simulation, each voice was played out of a different side of your speaker or headphones. When there were two people talking, it should have seemed like the voices came from here and here, and when there were three people talking, it should have seemed like the voices came from here, here, and here. But you know who's not here? Waluigi. This is the stuff I say between takes. This is done so the audio more closely resembles real-world scenarios. And this makes sense, right? When you're at an actual cocktail party, or any loud event for that matter, you have noise coming at you from all different angles, not just directly in front of you. This is, of course, the standard hand motion for sound coming at you. It's just common knowledge. Not to mention, having audio come at you from all different sides actually makes a pretty big difference when it comes to you trying to decipher it. When he did his initial studies on the topic in 1953, Cherry found that it was quite hard for participants to distinguish between two voices if they were both coming from head-on. Yet when he split them up, it was much easier. We'll come back to that later. While the cocktail party effect seems quite easy, after all, we do it all the time without even thinking about it, it's actually an incredibly complex mechanism. And to truly understand it, we have to understand three factors. Speech, masking, and attention. First, speech. While human speech arguably isn't the most ideal or perfect form of acoustic communication, it's actually pretty good for what it is. To understand why, we have to understand phonemes. Phonemes are the different fundamental sounds. They're made of 1 to 4 letters, and there's 44 of them in the English language. For example, if I were to pick a random phrase, say, Mimi Big Boy, we could break it apart and see how many phonemes are in it. Mi has 2 phonemes, ma e, big has 3, ba I ga, and boy has 2, ba oi. You know this. This is what phonics is based on. There are 4 ways phonemes are beneficial, as outlined in this 2015 paper by Adelbert Bronkhorst. Phonemes are pretty uniform across different people and different voices. They make a good use of the space allotted in your head to produce them. They're resistant to, but not completely immune from, background noise. And finally, and this is more of an aspect of speech itself, the information is redundant, which means if you mishear a couple of the parts, your brain can fill them in. The last two things on that list are what make the cocktail party effect possible. Since sound waves are fairly concentrated in one region, it'll tend to reign supreme and be hearable over background noises. And between redundancies in sound and redundancies in the English sentence structure, it's fine to miss a couple phonemes and still understand the person you're talking to. Side note, we can actually track the rate of recovery of lost information if a listener misses a phoneme as a result of a background noise. It tends to be around 50% if it's a real word and 20% if it's just a nonsense word. The percentage of recovery rises to 70 to 90% if the sentence is short and or common. Second, masking. Remember when I said we'd get back to the subject of hearing the voices from all different sides of the speaker? Well, now
past that time. Just because someone is talking to you on your right side, that doesn't mean the sound of their voice only goes into your right ear. Some of it also reaches your left. That means regardless of how hard you try, the sounds of different voices are going to mix, and this was accounted for in the earlier simulation. The process of different sounds, in this case voices, interfering with each other is known as masking, or more specifically, energetic masking, and the process of trying to separate those sounds is known as unmasking. There are a variety of factors your brain takes into account when identifying a certain voice and then unmasking it from others, those primarily being the characteristics of the voice and where it's coming from, but other minor factors include stuff like timbre, linguistic variability, and other things. Okay, we know how speech works, and we know how our brain separates different voices, so the last piece left in our puzzle is focusing on the one voice. Third, attention. This is an interesting one because attention has changed a lot over the years. Gather around and make sure you pay your respects as we discuss different theories about how attention works. Cherry noticed in his experiments that participants, even while they were focusing on the voice over here, could still, to an extent, understand and process the information said by this person. More specifically, they could understand when their own name was said or when the gender or pitch of the person talking over here changed. Out of this knowledge, two different theories arose, the early selection theory and the late selection theory. The early selection theory was proposed by psychologist Donald Broadbent in 1958, and it proclaimed that very little information and meaning is actually processed from the other conversation pre-attentively, except for information that really stands out to us, like our name, a gender switch, etc. The late selection theory was proposed by psychologist Diana Deutsch in 1963, and it proclaimed that information and meaning is processed up to a semantic level, and if your brain deems it unimportant, it doesn't go into working memory, but if it does deem it important, we're in business like a cat at 3 a.m. In 1964, psychologist Anne Treisman proposed something of a midpoint between the two models, dubbed the attenuation theory. This theory proposed that information and meaning is indeed processed, like the late selection theory, but the resources your brain devotes to it are minimal, and thus it takes much longer for the information to process. Finally, in 1973, psychologist and author Daniel Kahneman proposed something completely different in his book Attention and Effort. He suggested that attention works less like what we choose to pay attention to, and more like something with a capacity, where instead of I'm going to pay all of my attention to this, and none to this, it really works like this is what will take up most of my attention capacity, leaving only a little bit for this. So, which of these hypotheses are correct? We don't really know, and that's because any study concocted to test these theories tends to suffer two fundamental problems. First, shifts in attention are poorly controlled, and thus hard to monitor. Second, when we look at this through the metaphor of a filter, it implies that the sensitivity can be controlled as a relationship to an independent variable. However, we have no idea what this independent variable is or how it can be used to control the sensitivity of this filter. So, in conclusion, the cocktail party effect, or the ability to selectively listen to one person out of a sea of noise, works because human speech allows for it, your brain can separate or unmask the noise you want to listen to out of all the others, and you can continue to pay attention to the person you're talking to, as well as even interpret some data about the people you're not. If you too really like this sort of field of psychology, the topic of how your brain processes information, I strongly recommend the book Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman, who we mentioned earlier. I'm listening through it right now, and it is simply mind-blowing. I love it so much. And of course, the best way to get Thinking Fast and Slow is through Audible. Audible stands for, whoops, copied this from Jack's Films. Audible is downright the best place to get audiobooks. You get a credit every month, which you can spend on any audiobook you like. Credits roll over to the next month, and if you don't like an audiobook, you can exchange it hassle-free. Plus, even if you cancel your membership, your audiobooks are yours to keep forever. I genuinely use and love Audible. Like, some of the books in my library here include The Tipping Point by Malcolm Gladwell, Surely You're Joking, Mr. Feynman by Mr. Feynman. If you want to get your first month of Audible free and get a free audiobook right now, go to audible.com/technicality or text technicality to 500-500. You have literally nothing to lose. You support the show and you get a free audiobook. It's awesome all around. Go to the link at the top of the description or text technicality to 500-500. Ooh, hey, this is what I was saying in the 3-video cocktail party effect experiment. Pause the video if you want to read them longer. If you like this video, I think you'll like my other psychology videos, like You Don't Know How Toilets Work and How Food Presentation Affects Its Taste, which are on screen right now. If you want to see more, subscribe, and liking and sharing the video always helps. If you want to join the Technicality Discord, and I highly suggest you do, click the Discord end card right now. Thanks to all my patrons over at patreon.com/technicality, especially these awesome people. Thanks for watching DFTBA and Explore On.